Very warm regards to all my precious students of grade 3. Okay, now today I'm going to discuss the question answers of lesson number 1. Okay, see, these are the exercises that we are going to discuss today in this recording. Before we go to discuss the question answer, let me briefly recapitulate what lesson number 1, family trend, is all about. In this lesson, we had analyzed what is a family. A family is a group of people who may or may not live in the same house, and they're related to each other. Okay, and the people who belong to the same family are called relatives because they are related to each other, and that's the reason they are known as relatives. Family is very much needed to take care of you, to share your happiness and sorrows, and to also take care of all your needs, as well as to make your life more easy. Okay. In types of families, we had analyzed a joint family, nuclear family, and single parent family. In joint family, all the grandparents, parents and uncles and aunts and the children, they live together in the same house, and many members live in the same house, okay, including the grandparents. So this is known as a joint family. In the nuclear family, parents and their children live in the same house, and grandparents are not included in nuclear family. You only go to visit your grandparents and your uncles and aunts on various occasions and celebrate special events with all your relatives. But under the same house, under one roof, only parents and their children live. That is known as nuclear family. And the single parent family, a child and either of the parent, either it's a mother or the father, not both the parents, okay, you live with either of your parent, such a family is known as a single parent family. And then we had analyzed what is generation, first generation, second generation and third generation. Your grandparents belong to the first generation, and your parents, your uncles and aunts, they belong to the second generation. You and your cousins and your brother and your sister, they belong to the third generation. This is a family tree. You all belong to the different generation. Okay, you are not able to see your parents and your grandparents' childhood. Just that reason, because you were not born during the time when they were born, and they were small as children. So this difference of time is known as generation. The difference of being born and brought up, the time period when they are born and brought up, is known as generation. Okay. Working parents. In working parents, we had seen how both the parents, they work outside the home and also take care of the household work. They divide the task equally between themselves, both parents. So that and you as children should also take care of the household responsibilities if you are big enough to handle it. And in the absence of parents, you as children have to depend on helpers, or you are kept at the creches. Okay, in joint family, grandparents and other family members take care of the children of the parents who are working outside the home. Okay. Changes in family, I told you, it's either the increase in the family size and or the decrease in the family size. The increase in the family size happens when there is a new baby, it's the birth of a baby, and either a new child is brought into the family. You adopt a new child and the child comes from outside and becomes a member of your family. Then either of your uncle, they get married, and then your new aunt come into the family. That is the reason. These are the various reasons why there is increase in the family size. Decrease in the family size is, of course, the joint family breaks up, and then the members of the family, they shift to a new city, country or a place due to n number of reasons. The reasons could be finding a new job, or because if the uncle or the aunt is transferred to another city or to another country, they have to shift to a new house. And of course, if there's a limited space in the existing house, then you have to shift outside the ancestral home. Okay. Of course, the children, when they grow up, they move to another city, country, because they get better chance of getting education there. So they move out of their home. They leave their parents. Of course, they don't live. They come and visit their parents during vacations, but they go and stay in the hostel so that they get a higher education. Okay, and of course, if your aunts, they get married, they go out to the other family, then there is a reduction in the family size. And if there is a tragic death in the family, that is reduced in the family size. You have to always adapt to all the changes. Be the family size increase or decrease, you have to always adapt to the changes that happen to your family or to in your lifestyle. If the people, they come and go into your family, of course you have to manage all your circumstances. You have to adapt to the changes. And if your parents, they are working outside, you have to learn to be more independent and responsible. And that's the reason why you have to adapt yourself to the changes that is happening around you. Okay, so that's a quick recap. I told you about it. These are few of the words that you need to know. Household is a home where family members live and share meals. Okay, household is basically a home. Okay, creche is a nursery that takes care of young children. In absence of your parents, if both your parents are working outside, then you have to stay at the creche. Babysitters, they take care of you in absence of your parents. Okay, so creche is a nursery taking care of young children. Sibling is either your brother or your sister. If you have a brother, he is your sibling. If you have a sister, she is your sibling. Transfer is to move from one place to another. Okay, transfer due to job or due to any reason, you move from one place to another place, or to one city to another city, or to from one country to another country. That is known as transfer. Limited means small in size. Existing, that which is going on in present time. The events that are happening now, that is known as existing. Adapt is to adjust. Adjust to the new environment, to the new circumstances, is known as adapt. Okay, now we divert our attention to the solving of the exercise. Question number A, fill in the blanks. Number 1, a family having only one parent and her or his two children living in the same house is a single parent family. The answer is single parent. Copy the spelling, SINGLEPARENT, single parent family. Okay, the answer is single parent family. Family having only one parent and the children is known as single parent family. Number 2, we become a part of the family by birth, adoption or marriage. MARRIAGE, marriage. Okay, we become a part of the family by birth, adoption or marriage. Next, number 3. A generation means a group of people who were born and have lived around the same time. The answer to the fill in the blank number 3 is generation. GENERATION, generation. Okay, a generation means a group of people who were born and have lived around the same time. Number 4. A family changes and grows. GROWS, grows, when new members are added to the family. The answer is grows. Number 5. People who belong to the same family are called relatives. RELATIVES, relatives. People who belong to the same family are called relatives. Okay, next we move to question number B. Write T for true and F for false sentences. That is, you have to write T for the sentences that are correct, true, okay, and F for the sentences that are not correct, false. Okay, that are false. Number 1, we get to know about our previous generations through our parents or grandparents. So is it true or false? It's a true sentence. Write T in the first box. Okay, we get to know about our previous generations through our parents or grandparents? The answer is true. Okay, T. Number two, children form the first generation of a family tree. The answer is false. So who forms the first generation? Grandparents. Children are the third generation. See, I'll show you who are the first generation. Okay, let me show you. See, the grandparents. See, the grandparents, your maternal grandparents means your mother's parents. The grandparents who come from your mother's side, that is your mother's parents are your maternal grandparents, and your father's parents are your paternal grandparents. Paternal grandmother means your father's mother, and paternal grandfather means your father's father. So they are first generation and the children are the third generation. Okay, all you and your cousins and your siblings are the third generation. Your parents, uncles and aunts are from the belong to the second generation. Okay, this is what they have asked. So it is a false sentence. Children form the first generation of a family tree. The answer is false. Okay, children form the third generation, not the first generation. A family tree shows us the relationship between family members. Yes, true. Of course, the family tree shows us what relationship you have with your parents and what relationship your parents have with your grandparents and what is your relationship with your grandparents. Okay, so the sentence is true. The answer is true. Next, number four. A family in which only parents and children live together is called a joint family. False. The answer is false. So the family in which only parents and children live together is known as nuclear family, not joint family. Okay, this statement is false. F. Okay, next. Changes happen all the time. Yes, this is a true statement. T. Changes happen all the time. True. The answer is true. T. Next. Question number C. Tick the correct answers. So you have to put the tick sign. There may be more than one correct answer. So you have to put the tick in the boxes. Okay. The sentences which are correct, you have to put the tick sign. Number one, family members take care of each other by sharing happiness and sorrow, looking after each other's needs, taking care of only children. So both these sentences, sentence A and B, both are correct. Family members take care of each other by sharing happiness and sorrow. Tick in the box. Looking after each other's needs. Tick in the second box. The third sentence is not correct. Of course, only children are not taken care of. All the family members, they take care of each other and they share the happiness and sorrow as well. Okay? The first two box you have to put the tick. Next, turn to page number 7. Page number 7. Number 2. Family size increases due to birth, death and adoption. So what are the reasons why the family size increases? Of course, because of birth and because of adoption, not because of death. Because of death, family size decreases, not increases. So you have to tick the first box and the third box. Okay, next. Number 3, family size decreases due to birth, death, shifting to a separate house. So what are the answers? Yes. Option B, death, and option C, shifting to a separate house. You have to tick the second box and the third box. The first box increases, not decreases. Okay. Birth increases the family size. You have to write the reasons for the decrease in the family size. The reason of death and shifting to a separate house is correct. Okay. Number 4. Family members make the new members of family comfortable by being very strict with new members, making changes in their role, making changes in the space of the house. If you have new members in your family, for example, if your aunt, she gets married to your uncle and she comes into your house. So are your parents strict with your aunt? Will she be comfortable? No. Of course, your parents, they take more responsibilities and then they make changes in the space of the home so that your aunt comfortably adjusts to your new household. Okay, so the option B is correct and option C is correct. Family members make the new members of family comfortable by making changes in their role and making changes in the space of the house. Tick the second box and the third box. Number 5, families having both parents working outside adapt by sharing household work, fighting for easy work, employing helpers or creche. So how do the family members where the both the parents are working outside adapt? Of course they share. See, option A is correct. Sharing household work, tick it. And by employing helpers means you employ servants. Servants come and work in your house and help your parents to complete the household work easily. Okay, by employing helpers or creche, tick the third box. Okay, till here I stop. In the next recording, I complete this question number D. Answer the following questions. Then you get to know the answers of these questions. Okay, till then, happy learning, happy memorizing. Bye.